Chances are you know that Karen Truelove and Freddy Krueger are two of the best skiers in the world. But what you may not know is that these two first-rate athletes are actually married, which of course makes for a very unique and interesting life on the water.
So join us as MasterCraft looks behind the scenes at this husband-wife team and how they drive each other to the top of the podium year after year.
Hey, I'm Freddy Krueger.
And I'm Karen Truelove.
This is our place here in Winter Garden, Florida. This is Lake Huckleberry, where we live and work. We spend about 90% of our time here. And as you can see, we have an unusual morning this morning and no wind and good water, so we're not going to waste it. We're going to get out there and take you through a day. Got to push yourself past where you're comfortable, yet still finish and do everything right. And when it's right, when I land off the second wake, the time when I land off the second wake to the time I actually hit the ramp feels like it's, you know, I land and hit the ramp. And that's a little bit of what I'm fighting right now. Today, the first couple jumps, that time wasn't right. I had time to kind of sit there and know, you know, it was just a little longer than I wanted it to be. And when that happens, there's this just a split second of getting stagnant. And once you're not moving, it's hard to get moving. And so you don't crash very often, but the reality is for the first 40 feet that you come off the top of the jump, I always kind of say that makes the jump. You either came off and you had slipped a little bit on the ramp and you're trying to recover your position as quickly as you can so you're not losing all your aerodynamics and you're trying to keep your momentum going down the lake. But when it's really good, there's this teeter point of where you got it and you nailed it and you're moving through that first 40 feet and you're moving so quickly that it takes a split second to realize, am I right up over my skis perfect or did I go too far and I'm not, you know, and I can literally roll myself out the front.
I mean, that's what you do so well is you balance. You're usually so balanced into the bottom that, you know, it's a good place to kick.
As soon as I start feeling like something's off, she can very quickly kind of help me narrow down where I'm losing it, and then I can focus back on just my hips. And oh, yeah, she's right. I'm wanting to open them up, you know, to the ramp. I've got to close them off as I come through my turn. You know, those kind of things. We're a very good mix for, you know, her helping me isolate the problem, and then I can feel my way through a fix.
Things are right. They're just not right, you know.
And
that's how you do it.
That's how you do it.
I wouldn't mind trying that other fin, just to see if it helps with that.
I mean, it just feels too, like it just feels like everything's too good coming in, and then it just doesn't.
My 135 is my offside, and I have a tendency to not be able to snap the ski around as much as I can on the good side. A lot of people have that. And so I just felt like the ski felt like it was kind of, like it was stuck. It wasn't getting between me and the boat like I needed for it to. So, you know, I gave it 6 passes. And I was trying different things, and I kind of feel like, okay, well, in one of those 6 passes, I should be able to find a position to get the ski to do what I wanted to do. And if it doesn't work, then it's pretty easy to say that I need a change. So,
what we're looking for is a ski that, when she comes around the buoy, it finishes between her and the boat. And even if that means that it wants to stop a little bit or if it wants to shoot out a little bit, we'll take that as long as the ski gets around between her and the boat and creates her angle. Because from there, she can correct her body position and still get to the other side and keep moving down the lake. So I'm just going to take some measurements on this real quick and write them down so I don't, if I need to go back to this, then I can. I probably spend, on average, every day we ski, close to an hour here. And then there's a lot of evenings sitting down here building bindings and you watch us train, and that's great, but that's the embodiment of an awful lot of work that happens elsewhere, you know, and it's like any sport, NASCAR, golf, whatever. I mean, you know, you've got to have your equipment working right. So.
And then, of course, the second set, we were dealing with different boat position with the chase boat, and that was kind of strange because no matter how much you try to tell yourself, oh, it's okay, it's outside the buoy line, it's your eyes are still telling you you're going at a heavy object that will hurt if you run into it. So I had to make a couple passes to get used to that, but I feel like the change was good, and we'll kind of go from there and see.
As frustrating as it is for her to feel like, hey, my equipment's not working, it frustrates me as well because I can't figure it out, you know, and that's, but the really, really tricky thing is that sensation of my stuff's working really good, and then, but I'm still sitting here thinking, well, could it be better? You know, so it never ends, and like it's tricky, but I enjoy it more than I hate it, that's for sure.
He's more committed to my skiing than probably I'm committed, you know, I mean, and that's saying a lot, because I feel like I'm pretty committed, so it's just nice to have someone out there who's totally focused and, you know, makes you feel like you come first, so, I mean, I wouldn't have it any other way.